odor test is positive in. And first step is you should be able to know what is this amine odor test. You might have heard whiff test. You might have heard whiff test, but you must also remember the other name of the whiff test is amine odor test. So that is a step one. And step two is you must also know that apart from bacterial vaginosis, even in trichomoniasis also this whiff test is going to be seen. So the answer is option D. So I can see, you know, many students have marked this as option B. So I just wanted to clarify that whiff test positivity. So what is this whiff test basically? So the vaginal pH in these patients of bacterial vaginosis and trichomoniasis is going to be high. That is, it is going to be more than 4.5. And basically this vaginal fluid, when it gets in contact and it reacts with potassium hydroxide, then there is going to be a fishy odor which will be released, and this is going to cause the whiff test positivity. This is going to cause this whiff test positivity. And here you can see a positive amine test does not reliably differentiate BV and trichomoniasis, which can frequently coexist also, but for all practical purposes for your exams, the examiner will try to ask them separately. Okay, in this diagnostic algorithm which I will show in the next slide, there will be an elevated pH and a positive amine test, and the finding of increased PMN, that is neutrophils, is going to tell us that the diagnosis is trichomoniasis rather than bacterial vaginosis. So when the whiff test is positive, that is amine test is positive, then we should look at the neutrophils. If the neutrophils are present in the vaginal fluid, then we can diagnose it as a trichomoniasis, and if there are no neutrophils, then it is bacterial vaginosis. And I just want to ask you one more question. There is one criteria and one scoring system which is used to diagnose the case of bacterial vaginosis. So what is that criteria and what is that scoring system? If you know the answer for both these questions, do write it down in the comment section below. And if this explanation was helpful, please do hit that like button. With morbilliform rash, what is morbilliform rash? It is maculopapular rash, except, so you need to identify the odd man out. Myself Dr. Madhavan Srinivas, Sarvam Sri Krishna Arpanam Sarvejana Sukhino Bhavantu.